Recently, the Oliver Wyman Forum hosted our annual FRO conference on the transformative power of data, together with our longstanding partner, CG. We met in Rome in person and made the most of it, digging into the tensions between technology innovation and the concerns over financial stability. Of all the insights over the event, I took away four key takeaways. The first is it's not if, it's when. Regulators and authorities can have questions over the technology, but while they've been looking into the applications of it, pop culture has picked up some of these new technologies and run with them fast. The genie's now out of the bottle. The technology may not be perfect, and the future may not be crypto or NFTs, but the technology does work. And now you can have questions and concerns, but we're really in the early stages of beginning to think through what are some of the best applications and use cases. The second is it's not either or, it's both. We need to look at the power of technology and how we harness that, but also some of the practical challenges, balancing the economics with some of the social concerns, the inclusion concerns. The technology's not perfect, and with human behavior, there's always going to be uses and misuses. We need to get comfortable with that. The new technology won't just replace the old ways of doing things. More likely, they'll coexist side by side. And we need to think about how we integrate the two of them, how we handle a world where both of these types of technology exist. The third is it's not why, it's how. Against a really gloomy geopolitical backdrop, we mustn't take the rules-based international world order for granted. We've seen misuses of data, we've seen digital currencies being deployed in the wrong way, a weaponization of payments, and different restrictions in different geographies. What we need now is global economic cooperation and a shift of resources to focus on global growth. None of that's going to be easy. It's going to take a real concerted effort. And fourth, it's about looking both in and out, a point made to me by Connor McNicholas, one of our panelists. Connor talked about the tension between those cycles of innovation happening out in the market and then the central bank system that works to a slightly different time scale, and that disconnect happening between Gen Z, driving a lot of that innovation, and some of society's most fundamental institutions. We could spend so long looking inwards at our economic models, the rational actors, that we lose track of what's happening outside. The solution likely lies in trying to rebuild trust, of balancing those two, of looking inside, understanding those digital challenges, but also balancing that with a view of the outside, some of the behavioral, the cultural challenges. And it's only by connecting those two together that we're likely to find the solution. So what now? I'm excited about the future potential, but there's no clear path. I'm left with some pretty big questions over how we ensure we draw the full benefit of these technologies and applications for individuals and for society as a whole. There are some big gaps in understanding, in appetite, in readiness for change, and very different views on how we can align incentives to encourage long-term thinking and productive behavior, while at the same time, curtailing those activities that just aren't very good for society. And most importantly of all, I'm left wondering who actually has the power to shape this and take these decisions.